The department's just been on the phone to say Kelly's been picked up.
Yeah, where was she?
Adelaide. Couldn't pay a bill in a restaurant, apparently.
Surprised she could read the menu.
Makes you wonder what they use for brains sometimes, doesn't it?
Oh, by the way, how's Stan getting along?
According to the hospital, he'll be fine, but I'm afraid his days at Wentworth are over. So are his chances of getting Mitchell released.
Good. Early release just makes a joke of the court's decision, in my book.
Yeah, well, look, I'm pleased to hear he's coming along well, but I think he's going to do it a lot quicker with Mitchell here where she belongs.
I doubt it. And I didn't have the heart to tell him that he's under investigation for the Neville Sloan business.
You can't be serious. Why?
I hired him at Stan's request. I think Stan felt guilty of getting the job over Sloan.
That'd be right. He was always a soft touch at Woodridge.
He was a good officer, Mr. Murphy.
Sure, but there's more to being a good officer than winning the popularity stakes.
It'll be at least a day before Kelly returns. She has to appear in an Adelaide court to be extradited. Could you get a cell ready for her, Miss Ferguson?
Certainly.
You know, I'm all for raising the level of security after this escape. Teaches the others a lesson.
Well, at least we agree on something.
A prison's a prison.
Listen.
You surprise me, Warren, you really do. What makes you think you can run a book in here without me finding out?
Not me, Miss Ferguson.
Oh, really? And how did you pay Proctor for the goods he smuggled in? And don't try to tell me he didn't.
I don't care what you do to me. Please don't put Ray in.
Oh, Warren, I don't lag on people, especially if they can be of some use to me. As far as I'm concerned, you are Wentworth's bookie. In fact, I've got your first tip of the day for you. Kelly was picked up in Adelaide this afternoon. Why don't you run book on that?
Oh, I couldn't do that. I wouldn't be honest. I don't need money that much.
Oh, yes, you do, Warren, because you've got overheads. Me.
How much?
50% of the take, not the profit.
The take? I can't afford...
Oh, yes, you can, Warren. Otherwise, your friend, Ray, is going to be in a whole lot of trouble. Understand?
Can I have that sword?
You'd be the only one.
Okay, buy up time.
Oh,
people, we wouldn't want to cancel it, would we?
No, it gives me the creeps. He's always smiling.
Yeah, well, Stan wasn't smiling.
You know, it's a bit of a change for me having that lipstick and cosmetics at buy-up.
Wasted on this lot.
Oh, I don't know. As long as it makes them behave themselves.
Well, they'll behave themselves today. You see, they haven't had buy-up for quite a while.
Good. Useful little weapon, buy-up. Now you see it, now you don't.
Couldn't agree more. Come on, let's get to it. Okay, you lot, line up and do it quietly.
Hey, am I going to get a chance to get some of my money back?
Yeah, sure. What race?
Bugger the Gigi's. You're still running that Bible paper?
Yeah, picks.
Yeah.
The Bible stuff, okay?
Right. Oh, yeah, just this one.
We'll get a Bible later, okay?
No need to. Got it written down.
Oh, Pixies, listen to me.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. What's it from?
Pixie, what's it from?
Oh, I don't know. Gosh, you said hurry, I'm dying for my chocolate.
Pixie, where's it from?
Like I said, Marlene, I don't know.
I'm ruined.
Pay up.
Picking us off one at a time, you're going to be a bit short of punters, aren't you?
Take a walk, Mitchell. Now.
It's all right, Bobby.
Mitchell, sorry things didn't work out with you, Mr. Dobson.
Thanks.
Don't thank me. It's Stan I'm concerned about, not you. Hey, Warren, I didn't tell you about Kelly's capture for nothing. Where's my money?
It, Miss Ferguson. Half the take.
It better be.
Well, you haven't left me with much. What if all the favourites come in tomorrow?
Yeah. Risky business running a book, isn't it? Still, I'll leave you with it, Warren. That's your concern. Just keep quiet about it. Sweet dreams.
Yes, but they're mostly Daddy's friends.
It's always the way, isn't it?
Well, what have we got here?
Little accident, Mr. Murphy.
Yes, a
Pick it up now or I'll put you on a charge. Accidentally, of course.
Oh, hang on, Mr. Murphy. It really was an accident.
Another malingerer, Bryant. In fact, by the amount of work achieved here, I'd say you were all malingerers.
Well, we have stopped work, but we were talking to Pixie. She's very upset. She had some bad news about her family.
Yeah, parents split up after 25 years.
Oh, and I suppose you gave her some very helpful advice, Bryant.
There's nothing wrong with a bit of sympathy.
Of course not. It'd be right up your alley, wouldn't it? Let Pixie know that it's quite all right for a woman to live with another woman. That's how you operated at that halfway house.
Now, just a minute. How dare you bloody insinuate
that? Thank you very much, Bryant. You're on a charge of insubordination. Now get back to work, all of you. Well, I dished out my first charge this morning, and London to a brick, it won't be me last.
Yeah, who was it?
Bryant, insubordination.
Oh, good luck. It's all very well laying a charge, but I think you'll find the governor a bit soft when it comes to imposing a penalty.
They've got to support their officers, otherwise it leads to disrespect for authority.
Don't get me wrong, I couldn't agree with you more. It's just that in the past, I've found Reynolds far too lenient. She's made my job very difficult at times.
It's going to be a bit of a problem then. There's only one way to run a place like this, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, at last, someone who thinks the way I do. Now, you had me worried for a while. I thought you were another do-gooder. I reckon between us we can pull this place right into shape.
There's a few people around here need to be pulled into line. Take that lesbian Bryant, for instance. The less of her type around here, the better. The unhealthy.
Oh, hello, Len. How's it all going? Settling down all right?
Oh, starting to get a feel for the place.
Good. Tell me, have you got a family?
Yeah, two boys.
Oh, lovely. I bet they keep you on your toes.
Oh, not really. They're both growing up now, living interstate.
Oh, really? Oh, you must miss them.
That I do.
Yeah. And, tell me, what does your wife think about your move here?
I wouldn't know about that. See, we're separated.
Oh. Oh, I'm always threatening my husband with that. Mind you, I wouldn't do it. Norm says I couldn't live without him.
Can't beat a close family, Joyce.
No, you can't.
I must meet Norm one day.
Good.
Tell me, what do you think of Joan Ferguson as an officer?
Oh, you've asked the wrong person, really. Actually, I think she makes too much trouble amongst the women.
Trouble?
Yes, too strict, you know? I mean, they accuse her of being a basher and a lesbian and being...
Lesbian, eh?
Oh, well, I wouldn't know about that. I mean, that's her business, as long as it doesn't interfere with her work.
Of course. To each his or her own. Doesn't change my opinion of her in the slightest. Got your tongue wrong.
No, I just had a bit of stomach cramp. I had to sit down for a bit.
Not a fact.
All right now, though.
Ah, it's good to hear. But you won't be all right if you ever try lying to me like that again. You're nothing but a lazy, overweight liar. And I think it's about time you learnt the first rule of Murphy's Law. Lie to me again. Not ever. I could put up with queers like you at Woodridge. As far as I'm concerned, the less you lot around here, the better. After you.
There's my cut for the day, Warren.
Didn't run anything this morning, Miss Ferguson.
Your cash flow had better start improving, because scum like you are not indispensable.
Yeah, let's see a bit of rough stuff for the young'uns, eh?
What?
Make yourself scarce, Warren.
How dare you undermine an officer? That's totally unprofessional.
I just found out about you, Ferguson. You want to know something? I didn't like what I heard. I wouldn't put a dyke in charge of an outhouse, let alone a prison. Days of running this place are over.